welcome to a new vlog. It's Saturday afternoon right now and I just got off work. I worked Tuesday to Saturday this week and I'm also working Tuesday to Saturday next week. And the week thereafter is probably something different, but we'll see. Anyways, So yeah, work is still fun by the way. And now I'm just doing some YouTube work. Yes, it needs to be smaller and like put in the corner, that sort of stuff. But I also wanted to tell you something about my food schedule. Because for those who remember, I still order at rechtstreeks. So like fair for the farmers and you know, like close from where I live. Like everything comes from close to where I live. So it didn't travel half the world to end up in my kitchen. So yeah, the week after next week, I've ordered this stuff. This is a curry sauce, which I'm going to add tempeh to. I have never eaten this, but it's, I don't know, like it sounds like something interesting. The apples are just fruit. I either order apples or pears, because, you know, some variation is nice, but those are my favorite kinds of fruits, and they're quite cheap. And then these... They're a sort of red, big, like, vegetable thing. I don't know what they're called in English. You can Google it. This is what it's called in Dutch. But yeah, I'm going to make a curry of those three things. Obviously, the curry sauce. So that's going to be fun. And then I also actually ordered something else quite interesting for this week. Well, next week, really. Which I'm also going to show you. Yeah. The apples, they're not the interesting part, but these. Oh, this is also, by the way, quite interesting. I'll let you know if we don't forget how this tastes, because I'm planning this is like filet américain, but then with tomato instead of meat. And I'm kind of curious to, you know, taste it. And also vegetables, and vegetables are healthy, so I figured, hey, it's something else to put on my bread, because I usually eat like peanut butter on bread to work. So I'm gonna try that next week to work. But yeah, these... Crickets burgers. So like hamburgers, but from crickets. I saw it, I was like, that sounds quite disgusting. And then I got curious, and then I got fascinated. And now I really want to try it. I'm not allergic to anything, so I'm very curious when it comes to food. I want to try everything. So what I did was I ordered them, and I got them. By the way, this is also, this is how I plan meals. Well, plan meals. What I like to do is just make meals, put them in the freezer, and then during weekdays I don't have to worry about my dinner, because I have just, you know, well, I mean, I have to worry about it in a sense, or I have to defreeze something. Like, I have to take something out of the freezer and put it in the fridge the night before. But I don't need to worry about cooking anything. So I have these little things are ancient, by the way. I have no idea where... My mom actually once got them. This is the brand here in the back. but yeah, like these, they're just the perfect size really for like a one person meal. But this is spelled with mushrooms and, you know, not the hallucinogenic ones, just the healthy ones. Goat cheese and little tiny tomatoes. And this is a soup I actually showed you in the last vlog with carrots and tomato and some other vegetables that I still had laying around in the fridge. Anything can go into soup, and I just blended everything and all with a stick blender thing. Well, you could see that in the last vlog. I also ordered it Too Good To Go, where they're like, I explained that a little while back. Probably a year back actually. But that's something where you can order stuff for like 1/3 of the price. And then you get stuff that's like things that are quite, you know, they're still fresh, but they're not fresh enough anymore to sell. So instead of it going into the bin, they can still sell it to Too Good To Go customers. It's just an app on the phone. It's really handy. And what I like about it, it reduces waste, obviously. But also, it's just kind of surprising what you get. Like, you never know what you get, because that's just, you know, you can't choose. So you sometimes get really interesting stuff. But amongst other things, I got a bread. So that's living in my, well, not living, obviously. It's not that old. But it's in my fridge now, because I still had other breads. So yeah, this is just waiting until I go to eat it. Oh, and I also still have Asian stuff that I really need to finish. Like, that's my issue. I like a lot of food, and then I buy food, and then I need to finish it. And I really need to finish this, because it's like a year old. It's actually expired, but I'm pretty sure it's still good, so I might eat this on Monday. I also have blueberries and other, like, a fruit mix, like, in the back there. which are like, these are frozen, obviously, they're in the freezer. But these are like so good to make milkshakes or smoothies or ice cream out of. Like just stuff it in a blender with milk or yogurt or whatever, or on their own, and it's perfect. I love it. But yeah, the Cricut burgers are over here. According to the packaging, they're nice and crispy. They're a, I don't know how to translate that, but they're like a tasty bite. And they're a, how do I translate that? They're a good choice, like a conscious choice. Yeah, that's literally the translation, a conscious choice. So it's like healthy and stuff like that. Made of Cricuts. They've existed since 2018. I hadn't heard of them until now, but okay. And unlike the 8 minutes that it says on the front, if you're gonna bake it in a pan, it's 3 to 4 minutes. This is like the health values for those of you who are interested. I was mostly interested in how to prepare this stuff. And yeah. So there's two in this thing and they just look like burgers. But instead of being made of meat, they're made of basically minced crickets. It's fascinating and disgusting at the same time because really live animals and like, well, let me put it this way, live bugs are kind of creepy, but I don't really mind. But dead bugs, I'm terrified of dead bugs, but at least you can't tell that they're bugs, so that should be good. So yeah, I'm gonna make one of those on Tuesday, I think. And worry not, I will show you all about it. And I'll let you know what it tastes like. And I'll just make a whole deal out of it in my vlog. Because I want you to enjoy this with me. Or suffer with me. Potentially. I don't know yet. But yeah, that's just how I am. I'm not allergic to anything. And I'm really curious. And I know what killed the cat. But like, I just wanted to try them, so I'm gonna try them. So yeah, that's going to be interesting to say the least. I hope I like them, because there's two in a package, so even if I don't like it, I will have to eat the other one, because I'm against wasting food. Yeah. Or otherwise I'll just toss it in the soup and I won't taste it. And today is Sunday. I thought I'd just check in to vlog, because I haven't vlogged in a while, because quite frankly, I haven't been doing much outside of work, except for filming also and editing and watching YouTube videos, which is not very interesting to vlog. I really hope things are gonna open up soon again, so I can actually, you know, do fun things on my weekends, rather than sit at home. But anyway, what I did want to tell you is I started doing a different type of workout. I'll just scroll to the top of the page. It's this website. Whoop, yeah. This website. And yes, I know the guy has a lot more muscles than I can ever hope to have, but it has a lot of like exercises. And also they say that it's good to do exercises 2 to 3 times per week rather than every day, which suits me just fine because it takes less time. I don't have to do it every day. I don't know, like I just want to have more muscles. I like muscles, I want to have more muscles, I want to have visible abs. So yeah. Anyway, I thought it would just, be a fun challenge to myself. Yes, I totally still have to make my bed and hang up my, or not hang up, tidy up my laundry. But anyway, what I also wanted to tell you is that I made another concoction of a food. I've already put it on the floor here so I can show you properly. But it's this stuff. Wait, I'll just show you a little bit less awkwardly. It's red, I have no idea what they're called in English. Basically, they're just vegetables and curry sauce and spelt and also tempeh. Which I might be pronouncing completely wrong, but they're basically fermented beans, I think, sort of. Anyway, it doesn't have much, this is just chips of ice from the freezer, by the way. But yeah, it actually tastes very spicy and sweet, and I really like it, and I also have heaps of it, so I might better like it. Whoops, a phone call. Okay, the phone call was just my mom to ask if I could help carry the groceries once they get home, but anyways. But yeah, so anyway, I have like 5 portions of this, so that's gonna be good. So yeah, that's basically my little update for now. Also, by the way, about exciting things, I will just close this and stuff back in the fridge. Freezer, I mean. But anyway, my knees. Anyway, I did actually check my finances, and with like
the amount of money I still got for my last job, like the vacation hours are still left and stuff like that. And also my wages at my new job. I can buy a car of my own at the end of May probably, which is really exciting. So yeah, I'll just obviously show you that once I have it, and also the stickers I already bought for the car. The stickers are gold colored, so I really need to get a red car. I really hope they're going to have a second-hand red car when I have the money to buy one. Like, I want to save money first and not borrow money, just because that always takes more money, and I just, I don't know, I would just like to just have enough money to begin with and to just buy everything immediately. So yeah, that's really, really exciting. I'm really looking forward to that. So that's exciting news. And yeah, that's basically all I have to say for now. I'll try to find something else interesting to vlog so this vlog doesn't become too short. But yeah, I'll see you later. And it's still the same Sunday. I put on red lipstick. Do you ever have that where you just put on red lipstick randomly for no reason whatsoever, just because you feel like it? Because I really have that today. I really just want to wear a red lipstick for no reason. I feel vintage when I do that, even though I'm... well, vintage music, but not really vintage vibes in terms of outfit. I also washed my hair, did my bangs, colored my eyelashes and eyebrows so they're nice and colored again. So I won't have to wear mascara the next week, at the very least. By the way, I actually... yeah, I changed my makeup routine for work a little bit. Now I'm... although, you know, the brows and the... mascara won't be necessary the next week now that I tinted them. But when they're not tinted, I use this really old eyebrow set by Rimmel. I keep it upside down because there's also a wax in it. And if you keep it upside down, it's supposed to dry out less quick. Control Freak Brow Gel by NYX. My favorite Catrice Concealer. The Cream Highlighter by Yves Rocher I showed a little while ago. It's really, really pretty and natural. Also this lip stain, lipstick, plumpy lip... pencil thing by, well, you can see the name here, by Yves Rocher. I also use this as a cheek stain. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be used as a cheek stain, but it works, so I just do it. And a basically almost empty mascara, just because I enjoy having just a little bit of darkness in my lashes. And yeah, other than that, the rest of the day was filled with watching YouTube, and now we're just gonna eat, and I guess I'll just show you some shots of the rest of my evening. I don't know, like, when you have one spare... when you have a week where you have one spare day of the week, you kind of want to enjoy it. And the time is here. It's Thursday afternoon by now. Late afternoon. Almost time for supper. And I've planned my supper well. It's going to be the cricket burger with poached egg and a sauce of mayonnaise and onions, which I still have to make, obviously. Yeah. I hope it's going to be good. It's going to be, at the very least, interesting. So, let's go for it. then we're back upstairs. The Cricket Burger experiment has ended for now. I figured I'd just do it in silence because my parents were also downstairs watching television, so yeah. So I thought I'd just give you my opinion up here, my verdict on the burger. Yeah, it's not good, it's not bad. Let me put it this way, it tastes exactly like you would expect it to taste. Sort of crispy, but mostly a little bit dusty almost. Like it didn't taste like anything in particular. You know, with a real hamburger, you really have that nice flavor in it. With this, you have nice crispiness, but you don't really have much flavor at all. So the way I ate it today, you know, on a slightly toasted piece of bread. It was the end of the bread, so that's why it was round on the back. And mayonnaise and a lightly fried onion. And a little bit of a poached egg. That way it's definitely edible. It's definitely not bad. Like it's not, like it's very bland. That's the word for it. It's very bland. Like it doesn't taste bad within a meal. But I wouldn't eat it separately. You know, I wouldn't be like, okay, here we have like, you know, traditional Dutch meal. Here we have cooked potatoes. Here we have boiled vegetables. And here we have the meat. Cricket burger. Because if you eat it separately, it's just very bland. You know, it doesn't really taste like much of anything. So yeah, that's something to keep in mind. I will, because I have another one, I will try to make it more spicy next time. Because of course I could put spices on the burger. Admittedly, I was home quite late, so I made supper in a bit of a rush. So yeah, but I will try to like put spices on it next time and see how that goes. Because again, it didn't taste bad necessarily. It just, yeah, it wasn't very special in flavor. Like, I wouldn't buy it again for the flavor in itself, but, you know, it wasn't bad. That's basically my verdict. So yeah, I hope it was useful to you. And today is Sunday. Sunday, that was the Sunday. It's Saturday. A film today is a makeup tutorial, obviously, with pink and orange. Also, obviously. So yeah, basically my plans for the weekend are like, I have 2 days of weekend this week, Saturday and Sunday. So today is filming and tomorrow is going to be, you know, actual weekend and really not doing much because there's really still very little to do. I really, really, really hope that soon we'll be able to go to the cinema again and actually go shopping and do fun stuff and go to restaurants. Because I'm bored, like seriously, like the only thing I have to do outside the house right now is my job. And I really like my job, and actually we do have on Fridays, you know, a nice lunch together there too. But, you know, like, it's not the same, because in the weekend it's boring. Literally all I do in the weekend is film YouTube videos or watch YouTube. And it's getting just a little bit frustrating, I guess. But, yeah, that's just what we're gonna have to deal with for now. I think I might also actually fix my nails today, because they're a disaster right now. But yeah, I'll let you know if I do anything else interesting. And I'm also making some more suppers. I really like the whole keeping food in the freezer kind of thing and just grabbing what I want. But anyway, this time I got raapstenen. I have no idea what they're called abroad, but they're a typical Dutch springtime food and I'm making soup of them. I'm going to put a stick mixer over this once it's cooked. And this I'm just going to toss in it after the stick mixer. You can actually also just eat this raw as a salad. But like, I want to have some bigger pieces in there so you can still actually see, you know, what the soup has been made of. But it tastes really, really nice and fresh and spring-like and like natural. And like, it tastes like, you know, greens. It tastes like leaves, but it's just so fresh and so nice. And I really like it, so I hope the soup is going to turn out well. There's also onion in it, and what else to put in it? Garlic, and you know, just some other random herbs and all. So this should be nice. And I think it's pretty much good now. The onions have gone glazy, my camera is fogging up. I've also put a slice of bread in it to make it a little bit thicker, so now it's time for my favorite moment. The stick blender. And it's Friday again. It's it's actually not the last day of my working week. I had a really weird week this week. Like, I worked from Monday to Monday to Wednesday, yeah. Then I was off work on Thursday, and now I've worked today, Friday, and tomorrow, Saturday, I'm also working. You know, whatever, just how it ended up being handy in the schedule. And I've also, on that note, like, well, basically, I want to end the vlog here, but I do still have, like, some things to share with you, so let's do that first. And after that, we're going to end this vlog, and then the next vlog is going to start at Easter, which is this weekend, so that's the plan. Anyway, point number one, I fixed my nails. Let's actually start with that. I fixed my nails. And yeah, it's just, I actually filmed a tutorial of this as well. It is just a really easy look, a French with like some glitter. And it's very easy, but it's not only fun for Easter, but also, you know, after Easter when I'm actually going to post it. For like the entirety of spring and summertime, which is good. Just a nice and easy look. Also, I asked at work and there is no rules about how long your nails are allowed to be. We all know what that means. It means I'm allowed to do stiletto claws, but I need to be careful that I can actually type stuff with my stiletto claws. So I do need to be mindful of that, because there are old-fashioned computer keyboards there, which like the whole like blocky keys and all. So yeah, it's going to be interesting. Anyway, and I'm still contemplating whether or not, like, I think they're going to last longer than they did back when I was a postman, because I'm not going to abuse them as much. But still, stilettos do take more time to both build and maintain than short square nails do. So I need to like actually think of whether or not I actually want to make the effort. But I sort of do, because I do really love stiletto claws. So yeah, we're gonna look into that. But for now, they're just nice and cute and I like them. Yeah, other than that, to continue on the theme of work, I also, like, there's basically, in my job, there are, like, three different things. And I've now, this past week, learned the second of the three things. Like, two things of the morning and early afternoon shift, I now know. The other thing I still need to learn is, like, the late afternoon and evening shift. So, yeah, but so far, with the morning things, like, you know, you're supposed to sort of have it, like, in balance. Like, sometimes you do the one thing, sometimes the other thing. Depending on weeks or days or whatever. It's all in the schedule. But yeah, anyways, so far I don't really have a preference, quite frankly. Like, a lot of people like one particular thing more than the other. And most people like the same thing better than the other thing. So far I don't actually have a preference. Like, one thing is more, I don't know, with the second thing that I learned is like more on a schedule, in the sense of, it's very clearly defined what you need to do and when you need to do it. Whereas with the other thing, it's more like there are the things that need to be done, but you need to like schedule it yourself and you need to make sure you do it yourself. And there's also some jobs that no one is going to tell you to do, but they do need to be done, you know? Like, it's more of a self-reliance thing of like, you gotta put yourself to work. Which I'm actually used to as a postman anyway, and also as a YouTuber, so I don't mind that either. I don't have a preference, which I think is a good thing, because that means I won't be annoyed at either of the two jobs, so yeah. So yeah, or like the two things to do within the job, I guess. Anyway. But yeah, I like both, so that's all fun and all, and yeah, so that's basically my vlog for this time. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, amongst which this nail art tutorial, but also makeup tutorials, you can also subscribe to my channel. And for now, as always, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!